To help me situate this, let's look at image transformations in general. So far, we've looked at image filtering. Now what we're going to talk about is image warping or image transformation. So here, basically, assume we have an image, F, and what we're interested in doing is some sort of a transformation. So for example, what we've looked at is we've transformed this image to a new one, and here, hopefully, you can see that this image is now much brighter. If you remember what we've looked at before, one of the best ways of doing this would be to loop over the entire image and look at each and every intensity and perhaps do some calculations to it. In this one, I just added, let's say, 20 more intensity points to it. Now, of course, this image is brighter. Here now, let's do another form of transformation to get the output image G. Here, if you notice, what we've done is we've actually now stretched out the image. So if you look at this number of columns here, there are more number of columns here. Of course, so far, the same number of rows. So in essence, we've changed the width of the image, keeping the height the same. So in the case of doing filtering, what we're basically doing is we're changing the range of the image, the inside values of the function itself. So basically, to get the output image, what we basically have done is put in a function and transform the function itself to get the new image. In case of changing the size of the image and such, what we're basically changing is the number of things like rows and columns, the inside, not the content, but the indices of the matrix that we're changing. To do this, of course, we basically are now doing a transformation of the insides, that is the width and the height and all of the information associated with it, and that's changing the function. So the transformation, of course, in this one is the change of domain of the image as opposed to change of range of the image. Those of you curious about these terms, I encourage you to look back to your old calculus or algebra material on defining what is a range and domain of a function. And of course, here, our function is always an image.